Today we are going to take a new concept, that is curve tracing. So friends, we are already familiar with this curve tracing. We have gone through the tracing of the curves in our earlier classes. There we plotted certain curves by using our graph sheets, by taking the power values of x and y. So there we studied a very simple curves like y is equal to x square, y is equal to x cube, y is equal to 3x, like that. So these type of curves we can easily plot by taking the values of x and y by using the graph sheet. Now we are going to discuss a new way of tracing the curve to give a rough sketch of the curve. There is another method, that is by studying the properties of the curves. So based on the simply taking the properties of the curve, we can give a rough sketch of any type of the curve given to you. So let us see how to trace a curve by using these properties. So now, to trace a curve, here the curve will take different forms. The curve will be of three forms. One may be a Cartesian form. The curve may be Cartesian form. The curve may be polar form. The curve may be parametric form. So these are the three different forms of the curves we can observe. So here, what is the Cartesian form means? Here, your equation will be completely in terms of x and y. So you can easily identify if your equation is in terms of x and y, if the curve takes the form Cartesian. So if your equation is purely in terms of r and theta, then by looking at these terms r and theta, you can easily identify the curve is in polar form. Suppose if your curve equation is given in terms of theta or in terms of simply t, then you can easily say that the given curve takes the form parametric form. So there are certain properties to trace a Cartesian form, to trace a polar form, and to trace a parametric form. First, today we are going to discuss what are the properties of the Cartesian form to give a rough sketch. Right? So under this Cartesian form, the basic properties we need to study is symmetric property. First one, the very important is symmetric property. Then we will observe second property is we will find the points of intersection on the coordinate axis. So intersection points on the axis, coordinate axis. Next we need to study what are the tangents to the curve. So we will take the tangents of the curve. Next point we need to study is we need to find whether the curve is having any asymptotes or not. Okay. So these are the basic properties. After that we need to go to the next one. The first one is symmetric, second one is the intersection with the coordinate axis, third one is the tangents, and fourth one is the asymptotes. Now let us see what is symmetry. So here symmetry means, here we will observe whether the curve is symmetric about which axis, whether it is symmetric about x axis, whether it is symmetric about y axis, whether it is symmetric about both the axis. That part we need to check out first. So in order to check that part, how to check? Suppose our curve equation is Cartesian, so it is completely in terms of x and y. So f of x, y is equal to 0 is our curve equation. If we replace y by minus y in the curve, and you get the same curve, that means your curve is not changing. Did you observe? If you replace y by minus y and the curve is not changing, we are getting the same curve. So what we can say, this curve is symmetric about x-axis. Here we can say the curve is symmetric about x-axis. Now the second point in the symmetry is, if we replace x by minus x and we observe that the curve is not changing, then what we can say here is the curve is symmetric about y-axis. This is another point in symmetry. One more point. Here, if we interchange both x values and y values, and the curve is not changing, the curve remains the same. Again, so here we can say that this curve is symmetric about the straight line y is is equal to x. Similarly, after interchanging and taking the negative values of these both x and y, again the curve is we are getting the same curve. The curve is not changing. Then what we can say is this curve is symmetric about the straight line y is equal to minus x. Similarly, one more point here, if we take both x and y as negative values at a time and we observe that the curve is not changing, it remains the same, then we can say that the curve is symmetric about the coordinate axis. Coordinate axis in the opposite quadrants, the curve is symmetric. So these are the basic points to study the symmetric property. Right? The next one is second one is intersection points on the axis. Here we have to find the points of intersection. In order to find the points of intersection, if we put x is equal to 0, we will get y values. If we keep y is equal to 0, we will get x values. Similarly, if we get the point 0, 0, that means it is a point at the origin. Here what we can say is this point, this given term clearly passes through the origin. Given curve passes through the origin. If you get a point like this, some x value and comma 0, then we can clearly say that the curve passes through the x-axis. It is a point of x-axis. Another point, if you get any point like a 0, comma 1, then we can say that the curve passes through the y-axis. So, these are the points of intersection which we can trace on the coordinate axis. This is about the second property, that is intersection on the axis. Now, let us discuss third point, that means finding the tangents on the curve. So, let us see. Third point, to find the tangents on the curve, we will differentiate the given curve. Find the curve by dx. If you get this given by dx value is equal to 0, then you can clearly say that there exists a tangent parallel to x-axis. There exists a tangent parallel to x-axis. If you observe that dy by dx is equal to infinity, then you can say that this tangent is parallel to y-axis. That means there exists a tangent which is parallel to y-axis. So one more important point we can discuss here in the tangent is if we need to find the tangents at the origin. Tangents at the origin. So to find the tangents at the origin, what we have to do is we have to equate the lowest degree terms to 0. Lowest degree term to 0. Then here we can find the tangents which are passing at the origin. So after checking these points, we can find the tangents of the curve. Next one is fourth point. That is asymptotes. What is asymptote? Asymptote is nothing but it is also a tangent. So what type of tangent it is? It is a tangent which meets our curve at infinity. Which meets the curve at infinity. So asymptote is a straight line which meets the curve at infinity. So in order to find these asymptotes, what we can do? To find the asymptotes parallel to x-axis, equate the coefficient of highest power of x to 0. Equate the coefficients of highest power of x to 0. Then that coefficient should not be a constant. Okay? Similarly, to find an asymptote parallel to